Hey, this is Steven from QBox.com. Right now we have got Bow Wow on the line. What's going on, man?
How you doing, man? I'm pretty good.
All right, so you're about to start this walk across America. What exactly is the campaign for those who don't know?
Yeah, Walk Across America is a multi-city campaign that I put together to basically just bring the awareness and get the youth to come out and vote and just let them know how important it is. And that's really what it is. You know, it's a very passionate project that, you know, I felt passionate about being that I am an American. I live here in this country, and I see what's going on. I see the things that are being affected by this recession. And, you know, if I just wanted to do, you know, I just wanted to take on the initiative to be the first young person from the music world and the entertainment world to step out. You got guys like Puff. You got guys like, you know, different other artists that are starting to get involved with the politics and the political side of things. But they always preach on how we got to get the young people to vote. But it's kind of hard when you're not young yourself. So I figured that I'd take that upon myself to go ahead and take that leadership and the responsibility to go ahead and be the number one person to lead the youth to the polls. So what better other person to do it than myself, a demographic that I've been dominating for years. And, you know, so I just want to go ahead and share it. I'm a first-time voter, so I get a chance to share this with them.
All right, so what's going to go on at each of these city locations? Like, what exactly can people expect when they come out?
Expect big turnouts. Expect a lot of people who are not registered to get registered. A lot of people who haven't voted, they're going to vote. And basically, I teamed up with two other great organizations that are going to help assist me on ground at these locations to help people get registered and to get them to vote. So that's the whole entire objective, man, is to tap into the youth and get them and just raise their awareness and get them to vote. And also during that time, we will be walking by foot, by bus, and there's other different sources of transportation other than, you know, cars and the luxury things. You know, I just really want to keep it very simple up to what's going on now. And if you show them that if Bow Wow can do it, then they can do it too.
Who do you plan on voting for in the upcoming election?
Yes, I mean, when it comes to that, everybody's been asking that question a lot. I kind of just keep it to myself. It's kind of like a personal thing. The reason why is because, you know, I'm doing this campaign, and this campaign is for everybody. You know, it's just to raise their awareness and to get them the encouragement to get out here to the polls. So with that being said, it's kind of hard for me to say who I'm going for. I know who I'm voting for, but I just choose to really just keep it to myself because of the campaign. I don't want my fans, I don't want the people to think that I'm doing this to get people to vote for one specific candidate, and which is not the case. So I just try to keep the personal side of things out of what I'm doing. I just want to raise the awareness, bring it to the youth, get them to the polls, get them to vote, and you know, we're in a recession right now. I'm sure they know who to vote for.
Okay, so let's switch gears. Let's talk about music. You've got the upcoming album New Jack City Part 2. It's coming out. It was originally called something else. How come you decided to change the name?
The reason why we changed the name was because, I mean, Jermaine, New Jack City has always been our favorite movie of mine. And due to me and Jermaine, the creators had a lot of recent fallouts, which happened in the actual movie between Wesley Snipes and the guy, the same character who plays G Money, which was Wesley Snipes' best friend in the movie. And that's how me and Jermaine's relationship is. When you see Jermaine, you see me. You see me, you see Jermaine. And, you know, So Def was his label. And the Carter was actually, you know, Wesley Snipes and them. So that was their thing, you know. And it's kind of like we're using So Def as the Carter and how, you know, it fell apart once, you know, me and Jermaine split up. And now we're back rebuilding it. And that's, you know, the character that, you know, G Money, if he never died in the actual movie, then it would have been in New Jack City Part 2. So basically, we're just carrying on the legacy.
All right, so you got Marco Polo, it's the street single. That one features Soulja Boy. Did you work with him on any other tracks on the album?
No, just that one specific track.
All right, and when do you plan on releasing the official single from the record?
The official single record is going to be out, man, within like the next 2 weeks. So the album, is done, slated for December 16th. I can't wait. And, you know, the first single, man, it's going to be big, man. You know, every time I drop an album, it's a number one hit, you know, guaranteed. So I'm guaranteeing another one.
All right, so you recently had the showdown with The Game. It was very publicized. You guys played off. He ended up winning. Are there any hard feelings about this?
No, not at all, man. It was for entertainment, man. It was for entertainment purposes. It was to show that in hip-hop that we can come together. No matter what kind of music we make, we can all come together and get stuff done and work together and work amongst each other. So, you know, like I said, I'm all about positivity, man. And it was for a great cause. It was for charity. And as you can see, man, it just shows you that, man, you can, the simplest things in life can bring people together, man, you know, and you know, and that's what it was all about.
All right, would you ever consider doing a track with him?
Oh, yeah, of course. Game is one of my favorite rappers, of course.
All right. Do you have any plans to work with him in the near future, maybe for the record, or maybe just thinking about it for the future?
Probably for the future.
All right, so who else can we expect on the album? I know you got Soulja Boy, a couple other people. Who are some people that we can expect?
I got everybody, man. Swizz Beatz, T-Pain, Jermaine Dupri, Lil Wayne, T.I., DJ Khaled, The Dream, worked with Chris Brown, worked with everybody, man. Nelly, everybody who's basically out right now, I've worked with them. And I'm now putting together the official Marco Polo remix, which is going to have like 20 of the hottest rappers in the game right now on it. So far, I just got Wayne's verse. Twist is doing a verse. Of course, myself, I'm doing a new verse. There's a gang of people going to be on it, so I can't wait for the people to get it, to get a listen to it.
All right, when can we expect that remix to hit the streets, I guess?
In a couple of weeks. I'm still putting the finishing touches on it, trying to get everybody who I really want on it, on the record on it.
All right, was there anyone for this album that you wanted to work with that was just kind of unreachable or just wasn't available during the time of recording?
Nah, not really. I mean, I pretty much worked with everybody who I always wanted to work with. I had a chance to work with Legends and Madonna, Destiny's Child, so, you know, I pretty much work with them all. I mean, I'm kind of winding down on the music side of things right now, so everybody who's on the dime is people who I'm friends with, close with, and who I'm fans of, so I'm cool as far as features is concerned.
What else is next after acting in movies and coming out with this album and the political campaign? Can we expect any other ventures in the future?
You said what's going to be next, my next move after all of those things?
Yep.
Probably, man, just to keep dominating movies, man. That's why I want to finish up my career. I think if I can, I'll go so I'm 80. You know, be like Al Pacino, man. That's what I really want to do. I just really want to go into that and do a lot of films. So that's my main objective.
All right. Well, thanks, Bow Wow, for chatting with me. I really appreciate you taking the time.
Not a problem.
All right.